What up, guys? Video number one about the vlog that I just started. So it's gonna be about how to be ready mentally. I'm talking for dancing from what I know from my own experience, okay? So it might be different version, it might be different opinion about it, and I'm totally okay with it, but I'm just giving you mine, okay? All right, so to start, how to be ready mentally. A few things you have to think about. When you are in this business, it's not gonna be easy. It's gonna be super hard, okay? For many reasons. You are your own boss, you are your own manager, okay? As much as I know, the best work is gonna be done by yourself. You have to market yourself first if you want someone that jump in and be like, oh, I like what you do, you have potential, I'm gonna promote you, I'm gonna help you out. Before you get there, you have to be ready. So if you can't take rejection, you're not ready mentally, okay? If you can't take big, amazing news, you're still not ready for it. So you have to be able to deal with all the situations. The first one is rejection. Know that there's so many dancers in the world, okay, that are really talented. Probably better than you, better than me, better than anyone we could know. There's always someone better. Keep that in your mind. So based on that, you have to always to give 100% of yourself. So if you're not ready for rejection, you're not gonna give 100% of yourself, because whenever you're gonna be rejected, you might just give up. I see a lot of people posting on Facebook, and maybe he's gonna recognize himself. And he was writing, oh, this year is gonna be my year, and if I don't get it, I'm just gonna give up. And I'm like, you don't really want it if you already think about giving up. So you have to be ready to be rejected. Rejection doesn't, it's not a definitive no. The only way you're gonna have a definitive no is if you decide to stop, if you decide to quit. And that's the only thing that can bring you down. Okay, so I was saying be ready mentally, okay? Be ready for the two opposite, the two big decisions, rejection or acceptance. If you have those two big decisions, it's hard to handle if you're not ready. So you have to be able to manage both of them, okay? Then we're gonna come to a different thing. People that are too confident. You have to be confident. You know, like I said for my brand, stay bad, stay confident, blah, blah, blah. You have to be confident, but don't be overconfident. And don't have a low self-esteem of yourself either. So you have to find a balance in between those things. People that are too confident, I'm gonna give you some example. I've met people in my life, okay, that were a really good dancer, but not good enough. Not good enough, let me tell you why. Because they've been doing performances and stuff, and they have everybody telling them, like families and all the things. Those people are telling them all the time, oh, you're so good, you're the best, and da-da-da, and I never saw a dancer like you. But the problem is that those people that are giving them those compliments, they are not dancers. They don't look at the technical aspect of it. They don't look any further than just, oh, it's my daughter dancing, oh, it's my cousin dancing, oh, it's my girlfriend dancing, oh, it's my boyfriend dancing. And that's the problem right here. Those people, they think they're doing something good by giving him this compliment, and they probably think about it genuinely. They probably mean it. That's the part that where it's tricky. Don't take this as a final result to your level. I had someone that was really good, and then she was stuck because she kept telling me, oh, but everybody comes and tells me how amazing I was, and that I was so into it, and we could feel it on stage. They could feel how I was absorbed by the music and all those stuff. And when I saw her practicing, I was like, there's things that are missing, and she will cry. She would cry because she would think that I was trying to hurt her, and I wasn't. So make sure when you have those people telling you those things, make sure it's coming from the right person. If it's someone that has been dancing for 10, 20 years, have done a lot of different things like touring, stage performance, background dancer, whatever you can think of, but that has experience, and I can tell you, you were amazing. This and this and this was on point. That was perfect. Then you can be like, you can be proud of yourself, okay? But don't take it for granted, because whatever you have one day, you can lose the day after, okay? So don't take it for granted. People are gonna wanna hurt your feelings. There's some people that are gonna come, like, they're gonna tell you like mean things. Oh, you're not good. You suck at it. Same thing. When you look at those people, see what their background is, see what their experience is, see what your relationship with this person is, you know, like if those person doesn't really like you, they're probably trying to hurt you. So don't take it personally. Handle it. Be like, all right, cool. It's your opinion. It's fine. And move on. If those people have a lot of experience, you're like, look, this is not good. You've done this movement, or when you're on stage, we don't feel it. Why are you looking down, or why are you not looking towards the crowd? Like a little thing like this. If those people have experience, trust me, they are not trying to hurt you. They are not trying to put you down. They are trying to help you. Some people are gonna be really straightforward. I am a person that is really straightforward. If I see something that is not right, I'm gonna be, hey, oh my God, this is not good. You should try this, or you should try that, or maybe, you know, come a different way, and then, you know, I would be straight up. I wouldn't try to be nice. Trying to, you know, I was like, if you want to succeed, then you have to have the information right away. You don't have time to waste. So if someone comes and tells you you're not good, it can be two options. Or it can be three, I would say. They know what they're talking about, and you better listen. They're trying to hurt you, or they don't know anything. They're just trying to put a point somewhere, but they're just trying to talk for no reason. So just let it go, okay? The only one you have to care about is if they have an experience, if they know what they're talking about, then it's interesting for you to listen to it carefully. So that's those little things that's gonna help you to be ready mentally. Don't have a low self-esteem of yourself. Do not compare yourself to other dancers. There's many dancers all over the place, right? There's gonna be some that are gonna be amazing to your eyes and not as good to my eyes. Make sense? It's a question of taste, okay? I like the style of this guy, but not of this one. But some people is gonna be the opposite. Oh, I like this one, but I don't like this one. So don't compare yourself to anyone, but look around. Check out people. Look at their style, look at their technique, look at their musicality, look at everything. Once you look at all those things, well, say inspire yourself. You have to look around. You cannot get better if you don't look what's around. Once you know what's happening, then you're more likely to be able to handle every situation. The last thing is, do never give up. Never give up. I know if something happened, it's gonna affect your work, but try to, you know, put things apart and be like, this belongs here and this belongs there. One more thing, see where you're at. Look at yourself right now. Like, today it's January 10th. I am actually working. I have a full-time job, or I've done 3 shows last year. See where you're at right now and see where, like, what do I want to do? Oh, I want to teach classes this year. Or I want to go on tour. Or I want to be a background dancer for some artists. Or I want to start doing auditions or stuff like this. So see where you're at and then go from there. And then from that point, if you know where you're at, you know where you're located exactly, like, okay, this is where I am. I have this much work to do if I want to get there. So it's a little bit weird, but just like, you have to be able to deal with all those things. Deal with two situations, the really good and the really bad. Find the balance between those two. Then you're gonna have to handle the different kind of people that surrounds you. Your surrounding is really important, so make sure you know who is talking to you, who is criticizing you, who is giving you advices, you know? You have to take everything into consideration. Don't have a low self-esteem, but don't be overconfident. Never give up, and I think that's it. I think we've been to a point where you have all the key to be successful and to be ready mentally. All right, guys, I think I've been around the whole thing. I'm sure if you have any other suggestions, any advices that you want to give, please comment below. Share, like, subscribe, thumbs up, thumbs down, whatever you think. Thank you for watching, and see you for next video, how to be ready physically. All right, guys, peace, stay bad, remember.